Hello friends, welcome to today's tutorial. Today we are going to learn how to implement the reCAPTCHA validation in registration form using Spring Boot application. As you know, these days if you fill any form or the registration form, they ask you to just confirm that you are not a robot. So before moving further, I wanted to show you how our application will look like at the end. So this is the application which we are going to build, and this is simple employee registration form where you have to enter the name, employee name, salary, address, and here this is the important part. This is the reCAPTCHA, Google reCAPTCHA. Okay, and here they have to verify it is not a robot. So let's, I just wanted to show you one example. I give you some name, John. Okay, and give some salary random. I'm giving some random numbers, and suppose I give UK or London, whatever you want. And just I press on I am not a robot. I got this traffic light. Choose the correct one, like these three I guess is correct. Click on verify, and can you see it is tick mark? It means it is verified. And when I click on add employee, you will get employee added. And if you want to see it is added or not, just click on view all. So these are the things. Already I have entered the three employees. Now currently last one just now I have added. So you can see this is the list of the employee who is working in particular organization. So these are the things we are going to develop. So now let's jump here. This is the article I have written, and everything I have written in detail. If you want, just go through this article. I have written each steps how to build this application. So I will follow this article only, and I will explain you one by one, step by step. So the very first step, we need to create a project from the Spring Initializer. Just go to new window. I am going here and I will search Spring Initializer. I will come here and give the group name pixel trice, and give artifact ID, give any meaningful name so that it will be easy to identify. reCAPTCHA TCHA K reCAPTCHA app. Okay, and now left all as it is, and choose the first Spring Boot 2.4.0. right now it is the latest version, so I selected the first one. Add some dependencies. Let's check what are the dependencies we required. So here I have mentioned these are the dependency we want. What are they? Spring Web, ThemeLeaf, Spring Data, JPA, and MySQL driver. So in this tutorial I am using the MySQL as a database. So we just Spring Web, add Spring JPA, Spring Data JPA, ThemeLeaf, template I am using for UI side, MySQL, I am using MySQL here, MySQL driver. Okay, once done, click on generate button. Your project will start downloading here. Just once downloaded, just click on this and so in folder. Once it is done, just extract your project, extract all, and that's it. It will extracted in some place here. This is the path where it get extracted. Just import this project to your Eclipse or your favorite IDE, whatever you are working on. I'm using Eclipse here. So just Maven, existing Maven, choose on that. I will choose the directory where it gets saved. So this is the project where we have extracted. Just click on this and choose the select folder and click on finished. So once you done, you start importing here, and once imported we will proceed further. Just let it be like this and just move on to the article. Step number 2, click on generate, we have done. Step number 3, ngip extract completed. Step number 4 also completed, import in the IDE Eclipse. Now come to the important part. Step number 5, configure the properties in application.properties file. So what I am going to do, first I will copy this, and then I will explain you what is the purpose of this thing. It is, see here, it is get imported all the project. I will go into the application.properties file. I will paste it here. See here, since I told you I'm using the MySQL to storing the data as a database, so for employee details such as what are the employee details we have the like name, ID, salary, address, we are storing in MySQL database, so that it that all the properties we configure in application.properties file. Like this is the connection, give the username, your MySQL username and the password, okay. And since it is a JPA, so it is this properties, and this is DDL auto update. Okay, so this is the property we are using in application.properties file. Now move into the article and next jump into the another part. And here you can see I explain each and everything. So don't worry, if you want, just go ahead and read it. Now come to the step number 6. We need to create a model or entity class like employee detail. So what I'm going to do, I will just copy it and then I will explain you what are the purpose and why we are going to create this model class so that you can easily understand. So since I told you, I just remind you this tutorial I just made to give you the clear understanding of each line of code. My focus is to explain each and everything so that you can easily understand, and for the code also you can easily get this type of the code from anywhere. Or I am also providing, but the main focus is to just explain how all these things are working. So I have created this class here, employee entity. I will just paste it, that code. Since I told you, it is an entity class. Entity class means this class will be mapped to the table which is present in database or which going to be created automatically. Once we run the application, since we have configured the update, so it will automatically create the table in the database, and the name of that table is employee. We tag with the table, so this class will be mapped with the employee table, and these are the columns name. These are the variables which is we define or declare in the employee entity. It will act as a column name in the table. So ID, name, salary, and the address. So and here instead of getter and setter, just right click and add getter and setter here. So I'm going to add it here, right click, source, generate getter and setter, select all, click on generate. See, everything is done. Just fix what are the problem here you are getting. Okay, just fix it, rename the done, fine. One more error we are getting here, just one more bracket. So all this thing done, just jump into the article here. They see, if you want to know, I have explained you each and everything. Step number 7, create a class to declare the reCAPTCHA variables. Okay, so I will just create it and then I will explain you what is the purpose of this class, this CAPTCHA response type. So just I will copy it and come here. Control N is the shortcut to create class or interface or anything. What's the name? ReCAPTCHA. CAPTCHA response time. So I will paste it here. And see here, giving the error because it is different name. So I will just fix it, that error. Now see, here I have declared the three variables. So these variables is used in the, like it is used for the response, giving the response. Like if it is success, then it will give some message. So it will bind with some message and it is used as a payload. So giving the information. Okay, just it is a, consider it as a just like a model class only. So once any API returning any results, so it will combine with the success variable and the message will be displayed to the UI side like that. Assume like that only. I will explain you in the controller class when we are going to declare the API. So now come to the another step, step number 8. We need to create the repository interface for employee entity class. Since we are using the JPA and the Hypernet, so we just need to create the repository interface for the employee entity, and all the method will automatically come with this JPA repository class. That is the predefined class. I will explain you once I have. I will create here first employee repository. Sorry, control N, class employee repository. Okay, it's created, just paste it here, net code. So here the very first thing we have the repository annotation, and we are extending the one predefined class which is present in Spring Framework. See the package name, Spring Framework Data JPA Repository. Repository is the package, in that JPA repository class is declared. So this class contains so many methods to perform all the CRUD operations, like you can able to create the data in the database or the table. You can fetch the data, list of the data, and you can delete the data, you can update the data. All the basic four operations you can easily perform using this JPA repository, because all the methods are predefined. Just you need to do is call that method. And here, if you don't know, here we have to pass that entity class name, since we are using the entity class name as name is employee entity. And here you have to pass the primary key data type, that is integer. In this case we have the integer. Can you see which one is the primary key? Since we declare with the ID annotation in the employee entity.java class, so ID is the primary key. So what is the data type? Integer. So that's why we mention here integer. So now comes to the article again. Now we need to create the step number 9, create the service class for CAPTCHA validation. So I will just copy it, and then I will explain you why we are creating this thing. Control N, go to class and reCAPTCHA validation. I'm not focusing on the spelling name here, because I'm going to just paste it, and then I will fix it. Okay, see here it is giving error because name is different. So just fix it here, rename file to this, and of course you can give whatever name you want for the class. So it's up to you. So see here, the very first thing we tag with the annotation service. Since it is a service class, we tag with the service annotation, and the very first method we have, validate CAPTCHA. So this method will validate whether the CAPTCHA is correct or not. So here we are passing the CAPTCHA response, and it will pass, so it will actually, this method will get call from the controller class when we are going to create a one API. So at that point when you are going to save, see here, can show you, go to back here, see. So when you enter the name and salary address, and once you click on this, and once you verify all this thing, and if you click on add employee, it will call one API, and once that API get called, from here only this CAPTCHA data will go into our backend side, that is API side, and it will come here, validate CAPTCHA method. So that CAPTCHA response data will come from the UI side once you click on the add employee. Okay, once you click on the add employee, this one add employee, it will come into the backend, and it will come in this CAPTCHA response. So once it will come here, and we have created one map here, map object. So linked multi value map we have created, and we are set the secret, reCAPTCHA secret and the CAPTCHA response. This CAPTCHA response we are getting from where? From the UI side when they click on the add employee. But this reCAPTCHA secret, this we have to mention here. Here see, I have declared the final string reCAPTCHA secret, and here I mention your Google reCAPTCHA secret. So to getting this value reCAPTCHA secret, you need to first register on the Google reCAPTCHA dashboard or the that portal. Then you can get, once you register, you will get two things, that is, one is reCAPTCHA secret and one is site key. So once that thing is done, then this REST template we have. This is the REST template. It is a predefined class which is present in, I can show you where it is present, REST template. It is present in Spring Framework web client package. So we created the, and there is a one predefined option predefined method is also there, post for object. Okay, so it will call that object, and here we are passing all the values. Like endpoint, we are passing this. This is the Google reCAPTCHA URL endpoint. So basically, it is the endpoint or predefined API which is provided by the Google. So we are passing here in that site, and then and along with that, we are passing all the request map. What are the map we are passing? Request map. These are things that maps along with the secret and response. Okay, so this will go, and from that API, Google API, the CAPTCHA API, it will validate whether it is correct or not. If it is correct, it will return some API response or some values. And see here, we also given this dot class. Just I wanted to close this so that you can easily able to see. This is not required actually, extra tabs. See here. So here what recapture response tab dot class. So once it get validated, it will return the response in the form of this recapture dot class. So whatever the variables or the messages will mapped with all the variable which is we declare or be created in the recapture response time. Did you remember? We have created this class here. So the message whatever will come, it will map to the success variable. And the host name will map with this host name variable, and like this third or second one is also mapped with that some values from the Google CAPTCHA once it get validated. Okay, so that is the purpose of creating reCAPTCHA response time response type class. Now come to again here where we are a reCAPTCHA validation service class. So once it validated from the Google app reCAPTCHA API, then it will return some response. So if it is null, it means that is not correct, means it is false, validation is failed, that means. But if suppose it contains some values, then it will return that is true, and then the employee detail will be automatically saved into your MySQL database once this process is completed. So that is all the things, but here important point is you should know how to get this as your secret ID, Google reCAPTCHA secret ID. So I will guide you. Now come to the article. I have also written how you can get that thing in the next step. See here in the step number 10. So we need to create a account on Google reCAPTCHA. So what I'm going to do, I will just go here, and here I provided the link. Go to this link. So here I have provided the link from where you can create the account in Google reCAPTCHA. Just right click and open, or just I'm copying this, copy this link address. I will open in the guest window, so I will explain you easily. See here, I have opened here, and here first you need to register. Here provide your email ID. I'm providing my site email ID here. See here, I have signed in here. Now see, the very first thing you have to provide label. You can give the label, use the label that will make it easy for you to identify the site in the future. So just I am using for my local system, I will give any label name, localhost or local system, I will give for local system. Okay, and here we have the options to choose. Either you can select the reCAPTCHA v3 or you can choose the reCAPTCHA v2. And if you go here in the reCAPTCHA v2, it is provided the option that you can choose either of three things. I am choosing the first one because it is like good. I am not a robot checkbox. It provide like that. So what this means, it will look like this. This is I am not a robot. It's look very real, right? Actually all are real, but this is I saw in so many sites. People are using this thing. So I just use this. Now here you have to provide the domain name. So if you are using any or integrating this reCAPTCHA thing in the real projects, or you having some domain name with .com like that, you have to provide all the domain name, correct domain name. Example for here it is also given the example, that is example.com. okay, so here we are going to use in just on local system. So I will provide local host here, and owner is already there, my email account, Gmail account. Now what I'm going to do, I will just accept reCAPTCHA terms and condition and click on submit. So once you click on the submit, you will get two things. That is, one is site key. Earlier, did you remember? I told you we will get two things, site key and the secret key. So this secret key, we are going to just need to copy it and just go here, and you have to just place it here. Okay, this is the secret key. Now another code we got from here, that is the site key. I will explain you when we are going to use that HTML. Actually, we need to use in UI part of code, that is in HTML. Okay, so once I am going to implement the HTML, I will definitely explain that thing also. Now come to the article once again. Everything is done. Now here I have showed you the steps how you have to follow this to get your site key and the secret key. Next step, the very important, that is we need to create a controller class. And you see, we need to create a controller class in this step. So what I am going to do, I am just copying it, and then I will explain you what is the importance of this controller class and where we are using it. So just I am copying it. I will just go to here, control N, and choose class, give employee controller, and paste the code. See here, it is a controller class, so we tag with the controller. And the request mapping, we use this to just make the API specific to the class. Okay, so whenever anybody try to call any API, for example register API or the save API, they first have to just enter employee also. They have to follow with employee or this API. Okay, then only they can directly able to call any API. So I will show you when we run it how we are going to use this thing. So now the very first method we have, SoRegister, and this is the API which is used to get called when you call the registration form. So once you call this API, it will return the employee registration. Okay, the employee register. Actually, since we have implemented the theme leaf, so it will return employee register.html. Remember that. It might be look like it is a string here, but it is actually returning employee register.html. So we must have the .html thing in the template folder. This is the template folder. Can you see it? Source main resources, under that there is a template folder. There must be one .html file with the name of employee register. Now come to the another method we have, save employee. This is actually get called when you click on this add employee button. Once you click on this, this API get called, save employee API, and it will accept the, what it will accept, it will accept the request parameter, that is gRecaptcha response. The recaptcha response, it will accept in this parameter once you click on the add button. So after that, see here, I told you it is validating, we are validating that captcha is correct or not. So it will validate the captcha, and this method validate captcha is already we are calling, and it is declared in this class recaptcha validation that I already explained you earlier. So this captcha response is coming from the UI side, and it will finally validate whether it is correct or not. If it is correct, then it will return this true. Okay, so that is the thing we have doing from the controller class. So once it verify, then further what we are doing, we are just saving into the employee details in the MySQL database. So see here, it will, once it return true, then the if block code will get executed, and the very first line will save the data in the MySQL database. So once it gets saved, then we are just appending that thing, employee object in the model. Okay, employee object in the model, and the message also we are appending, and the message what we are giving, employee added. So okay, this will come once you click on the add employee button in US head, you will able to see the employee added message just right below of that button. So this is the if part, but somehow if anything is get wrong, so it will execute the else part, and that will show please verify the captcha first. If you click on add button and if the validation get failed, then the else part will get executed, and it will display the message please verify the captcha. Okay, and finally it is returning employee register, and it might look like a string, but it is actually returning the employee register dot html. So there must be an employee register dot html in the template folder. So two html file we need to required here. One is employee register, and above also it is returning employee register. So one is we saw already, and another thing, another html file we required employee data. So why it is required? The purpose of this to get all the details of the employees. Can you see this is the last API we have added, get all employees. So once did you remember, once come here, I will show, wanted to show you, if you click on view all and you see it is called the API employee all, and this is the index, that is the HTML page which you are seeing. It is actually the HTML page, and that is the HTML page what's name employee data dot HTML. Still we did not create it, I will create it and then I will show you when we are going to run the application at the end. So that is the thing. Now come to the article again. Step number 12, create the HTML file. We need to create two HTML files. First one is the employee register dot HTML. Which one is the register form? This is this one. This one is actually the employee register dot HTML. So I will just copy it, and it is very simple HTML. If you know little bit of tag or form tags, you can easily understand by looking at this code. So just go here in the inside the template, right click new file and give the name employee register dot html. Make sure the name should be match with the controller class employee register. Okay, if there is any mistake then it will not return anything. All right, and see here I also use the bootstrap for like designing purpose or coloring purpose. If you see that this thing, if you see the blue color, green color like that, this is because of bootstrap. That is the library of CSS, styling purpose. So that is the link here. I am just attached that link. It is automatically working. And this is, these are the predefined class which is present in the bootstrap framework. Okay, this is not much required for our understanding, but if you know, if you wanted to learn, it's very good. It's very easy actually. You can easily understand all these things. So here the one thing I wanted to show you at this point, deep class gRecaptcha data site key. Can you see data site key? Here you have to enter the site key. So whatever the site key we got from the UI that Google captcha here, secret key you already I showed you, you already entered in the server side. Okay, now the copy the site key, and that site key you have to enter here in the data dash site key variable. Just remove this and paste it yours here. Once done, now another dot html file we need to create. And actually this is the employee register dot html, and it will look like this. Where it is, come back, this it will look like this. This is the dot html file, and here it is basically a form. So that's why I use the form tag here. Okay, that's why I use the form tag, and just name and all the things, salary and everything. It's very easy. If you just go through that, you can easily understand. Now the another dot html file that we need to create, just go here template, right click new file, and the name of that employee data. Okay, make sure the name is correct whatever you enter in the controller is class. Okay, employee data, just verify it is correct or not. Go to the controller class. Where it is? Controller class. This is the controller class, the last one employee data. So this is employee data. Yeah, it is correct. And just I will paste it from the article, and then you will easily understand. So just what I'm going to do, this is the employee data dot html. I will just copy it, and it is also very simple. It's just a small tag, html tags, and bootstrap for the CSS purpose. These two links are bootstrap. And see here, it's a very simple here employee registration page. So this is, can you see employee registration, employee register page. So this see, actually it is representing this page, employee registration page, and it will display the list of employee detail which is already registered in our database. So now come to the article once more time, and yeah, we are good to go. Just run the application and go to here, you will able to see this page. So let's go and run the application. So just come here and go to Spring Boot main class. Okay, and just come here and just right click and run. But before running it, I wanted to show you one thing. This is the MySQL workbench, and this is the database or the schema captcha app name. And currently you can see in the tables, there is a no table still has been created. So when we run the application, the table will automatically get created, and the name of the table will be that employee. So let's just come here and right click and run the application, and I hope it will run perfectly, and let's see. So it is started running here, starting running, and finally let's see. Yeah, can you see it started Spring Boot application on port number 8080. Now go to here MySQL, and still we can't see the table. Just what you have to do, just right click on the schema or the that database name and refresh it, refresh all. So can you see that employee is coming here? That is the thing I wanted to show you. Just if you want to see the thing, it is created or not, can you see it is created ID, address, name and salary. Now let's go and check it is working or not, it is running or not. Come here and type localhost 8080. Okay, you got here, and just go here employee and register API. So once you go here, it will return the form. See, this is the form, and that form is basically, if you remember, just go to the employee controller and show you from where it is coming. So see, this is the register, and we start with employee because this class is having the request mapping employee, and it is returning the employee register.html. So that is the employee register.html page, this one, and give some name here, employee name, give some salary and address. Okay, and verify here I am not a robot. Just verify here, I hope it is correct. See, 3 verify. Yeah, verified, and press on add employee. Once you press it, can you see it? It is showing employee added. So once you press it, that employee get added, and where it is get saved in the MySQL database. Just go here. See, currently we don't have, just execute this query to see the result. Can you see ID 1, address India, name Rahul, and salary? It is saved. It means it get added. Now see, if you want to see in UI side, just click on view all button, and it will call the employee all API. And here you can able to see that employee details. So that's all about guys. These are the things I want to teach you or want to explain you. And remember this Google reCAPTCHA site key and the secret key never share to anyone. This should be the private. Okay, so I am showing here, I will delete it after making this video, so anybody cannot misuse this thing. So don't share with anybody, right? So, and I also written the article here. If you face any difficulties or the problem, just go through this article. I explain everything, and at the end I also provided the source code here. Download the source code, you can download the source code from here. And yeah, that's all about guys. If you have any queries or the difficulties, please do comment in the comment section. I will definitely answer your queries. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you learned something, and good luck.